Hello, everybody. So we are on our way to see our first house. This is one that honestly ticks pretty much every single box on our list, which is crazy. There's one box that it's not ticking, which is it's not very rural. It's in a city, but every other box. So this one for us is like kind of really high up there. We have high hopes. Things seem to be selling pretty quickly too, so anywho, we'll see. We'll take you guys inside with us. So the first house we went to see, we were in love with it before we even saw it in person. It had this amazing like living space that was attached to the kitchen that we thought we could totally just knock out that wall and have this like perfect sized entertaining space. It had original hardwood, which my heart was just like screaming over. And it had an archway.
Ugly one, but one.
It was still an archway. So yeah, I mean, I really loved the entertaining space.
The bedrooms were tiny, but again, there was two of them, two plus one kinda, lacking closet space, but they were fine. They were workable. Nothing to write home about.
The bathroom was just renovated. I really did like the floors. It was a great bathroom. It wasn't like perfectly my taste, but it was a bathroom.
The kitchen was very basic. Again, it was something we could renovate to add value later. Once we opened it up to the living space, I'm sure it would be great. Right now, it had nice appliances, had a dishwasher, which was great. But yeah, nothing too special. Kind of ugly at the moment.
Yeah. It did have a basement, which was renovated. It did have a bedroom in the basement, but it had this like weird, you had to like go into this unfinished laundry room in order to get to this bedroom. So it was a little strange.
Yeah, maybe like a bonus room, put like the spin bike in it or something.
Yeah, something.
But, yeah.
But there was a bathroom downstairs as well. It needed updates.
Second bathroom was a huge bonus though.
Yeah.
Just to have two would be great.
And that amazing wall that was like down there, the wood wall, I love. That was super cool.
And I actually like the carpets in the basement.
There are two really amazing things about this home that we love. The yard. I am such a big fan of a wide lot. I just think it gives you a little bit more privacy in between your neighbors. It was just like the perfect sized backyard. I loved it. So did Michael.
It had a garage.
Yeah.
A detached garage. Looked to be in reasonable condition.
We are looking at our second house. Where is it? It's right there. I loved the curb appeal of this home. I thought it looked really cool, so we just like sort of gave it a shot. The big problem with this home was it was radiant heat, and radiant heat, if you guys don't know, is expensive to run, and you just don't want a house with radiant heat. We just thought, let's look at this house. It's really cute and see.
Yeah, it had a lot of other things going for it.
The first thing we noticed that was a little strange to us was that the bathroom, there was no bathroom upstairs. The bathroom, like with the tub and the shower, was actually like off the dining room, which was a bit strange.
I'm not sure if like I could do the only bathroom on the main floor, like so far from the bedroom.
The kitchen, kind of a weird layout.
Yeah, everything was nice and updated and it looked like aesthetically pleasing in photos. But when you got in there, like the fridge was blocking the door to the basement.
Yeah, the fridge.
So we'd have to do something about the layout of the kitchen if we were to live in this house every day, I think.
Going upstairs, stairs were carpeted, which we did like. And I think all of the bedrooms were also carpeted. I like the bedrooms, a three bedroom house. But like still, no bathroom upstairs, which I think, I don't know. Flooring, really nice upstairs as well too. I don't know. The radiant heat, the bathroom, the weird kitchen. It didn't scream like I'm the one. So we are currently in the car. We are on our way to see our third house. This house is in the exact same area as the last house. So as far as our need list goes, we are hitting everything. The want list. It's not rural, which is you're obviously noticing is a common factor in a lot of the places we see. This doesn't have a garage. It does have a basement. It's a bungalow. Yeah. Doesn't have original hardwood, but it does have an archway. So, you know, hit and miss on the want list, but we're still pretty excited to see it. So let's go inside. The last house that we saw had really great curb appeal.
Yeah, this was the best looking one from the street.
This house was in a totally different location than the first house we saw. It had a smaller backyard, I'd say, but it had a lot of side yard on both sides of it. Going into the house, so it had this living room and then you kind of had to go into this kitchen. We don't like that. We liked kind of more so having a little bit more open space.
The living space left a lot to be desired. There was not very much of it. I think we would probably need to take out a bedroom and add it as living space in this house. But so much else was nice that I feel like we could handle that.
It had 3 bedrooms, 2 really big bedrooms, and 1 teeny tiny bedroom. There was no back door. There was only a side door, and I did not like that. But that master bedroom was a great size. I could see myself living here, which was something I couldn't see myself living in the last house we looked at. So that was like huge for me.
The basement too, the basement. It had a like a beautiful unfinished basement, but really high ceilings and so much room to improve down there.
Which again was something we were looking for, something to invest a little bit of our time and money into. Do you have a favorite house?
Hands down, yes. I have 2. But I have 1 undisputed winner.
I have 2 as well. House 1 and 3.
Yes.
Yeah, okay, obviously.
And for me, house 1 is in another league. Like,
I'm leaning a little bit towards 3.
Oh, I'm all the way in on 1.
Okay, so 3, I like the location a little bit better. But 1, I like the house better.
I like the neighborhood of 1 better, and the lot is just unbeatable. We didn't talk about this before, but it had like what must have been an RV parking space on the side.
Oh yeah, this amazing spot to put the studio.
It was like an elevated ledge in the yard, in the back corner.
And the trees.
Trees covering it, like it would have been a great spot for the studio.
You're right. We have obviously talked about what we want to do here, so I just want to tell you, be straight with you. Like, so what we think we want to do is put in an offer on house number 1. We love house number 3. The thing is, we know house number 1 is going to be a bidding war. We know we're gonna have to go in over asking. We know that like they're gonna have a ton of offers. So we are worried that we're not gonna get it, if we're completely honest with you. So yeah. We love 3-2 and we're okay. And like we think we would wanna also put an offer in on 3 if we don't get 1.
Yeah, exactly. I would be happy in house 3-2.
So that's basically where we stand right now. I guess we'll let you guys know. I will update you and cross your fingers that we have house 1.
It looks like the best investment too. Okay. But I'm getting too ahead of myself. I'm way too excited.
Okay,
we're so probably not gonna get it.
I know. Okay, we will update you as we go. Hi guys. I have to film this update. As you can tell by my mood, the house that we really liked that we decided to put an offer in on, we offered $10,000 over asking because we knew that it had a lot of viewings. They were also holding offers, which basically means they were showing the house for a week and you could put an offer in on the following Tuesday. Holding offers, you know, can typically mean that, like, you know, a lot of people are viewing it. We knew a lot of people were viewing it because we saw the amount of real estate agent cards. Anywho, so we knew it was going to be a little bit of a bidding war, so we offered $10,000 over asking. The house ended up selling for $60,000 over asking, which we just, like, I don't understand. I don't think it was worth $60,000 over asking. Maybe once it had like been renovated, but yeah. So we didn't get that house. So we ended up putting in an offer on the 3rd house that we saw. And I just have to say like a couple things going into this, which I didn't say in the beginning. Number 1, we did see other houses. These were just the notable ones that I wanted to show you guys. So it's not like we saw 1 house and put an offer in on the first house we saw. And number 2 is, like, in the area that I live in, like normal sized houses, they go from anywhere between, I'd say, like $300,000 to like $800,000. So like, I know in some places, like, you can get a mansion for nothing, you know. Yeah, the housing market where I am is very competitive. We offered $12,000 asking for house number 3, and it sold for I think $33,000 over asking. So we were just sort of like, okay, I assumed that because of like what's happening in the world, like with like COVID, I don't know, like maybe there's just like people desperately need, there wasn't stuff on the market for a while, so people obviously always need to move. So anyways, we didn't get either house and we are feeling like quite disheartened. If I'm honest, I'm exhausted, I feel, but the search is going to keep going on and we're going to keep trying. And so there's going to be obviously a part 2 to this video. Just wanted to share the news. Like, I obviously know like whatever is meant to be will be, and we will find, like we will find the house. I know. It's just tough. Anyways, guys, there will be an episode number 2, and that's all I gotta say for now. I'm just tired. I will talk to you guys later. Bye, guys.
On the next episode.
It had great hardwood floor. It actually was a really cool color. As soon as we opened that door, you were just hit with cat urine. Those high ceilings in the bedroom. Oh, I love.